We had this kid we were working with, was waiting on a heart transplant. This kid was in the hospital for 10 months. Obviously, as a parent, it'd be ideal if my kid was running outside on the playground with his friends. But if it wasn't for video games, he probably would go insane, because it's really thanks to Minecraft, he's able to have any type of social interaction with his friends that feels meaningful. Not only did he feel like at least he had some connection to his friends still, which helped make that time seem less burdensome, but his friends also didn't forget about him. I mean, we had another kid who had a really severe burn on his arm, and every few days, nurses were coming in to change his bandages. It got to a point where like 6 nurses were holding this kid down because he was so anxious over the procedure. One of the nurses wheeled in one of our go-karts that we build, let this kid play video games for 30 minutes to ease his anxiety. And it went from 6 nurses holding this kid down to 2. And so all of a sudden, you know, you can say like, hey, games are a helpful tool. This kid was, I mean, nobody's trying to make this kid have a worse experience in the hospital. Now all of a sudden, like this child, you know, he's able to use video games as a coping tool to ease his anxiety. The nurses are having an easier time doing their job. And then there's an economic argument to be made for the hospital, because those 4 other nurses can go and support other patients. We recognize that there's, you know, massive benefit to the existence of video games in hospitals. Like, games are making a tremendous impact on these healthcare facilities, but they're also helping with the healthcare process.